Hello everyone, welcome to Piano World, this is Emma Newman. Loose hands. So this is a topic I will never stop talking about because every single student has this issue at some degree. And in the past I have made a couple of videos about the same topic. You can check it here or in the description below. So how can I describe this feeling? Loose, light, empty, relaxed, sleepy, lazy hands, hands that don't exist. This is so crucial to get this feeling because this is number one reason of any uncomfortable feelings while playing, even in slow tempo, that also can lead to some pain and injuries in the future. This is number one reason that prevents students from getting a sensation of cleaning fingertips, and surprisingly this is number one thing that no students nor teachers usually aware of, because from the teacher perspective it's really hard to say whether students play with loose or stiff hands unless teacher just, you know, come to the student and touch the hand, and then probably the teacher could feel if the hand is heavy or light, but not every teacher does this. Especially if we're talking about the higher level of education, like professors would never do this. Professor, he would just like walk back and forth talking about some art, or sitting on the couch talking about some art with you. He would never come and touch your hand. And from the student perspective, it's also hard to feel because he simply never got this feeling, so he has no idea sometimes that he's playing with stiffness in hands. He has nothing to compare his sensation with. So, the reason of this unnecessary tension is this energetic stiffness within the body when students try to play more expressive, as again their teacher would probably ask them to do, or overcoming some technical problems. But because they don't know how to do this exactly, they would naturally start just get more stiff inside, you know, trying to make something better. And unfortunately muscles would get used to this feeling, completely forgetting how it actually feels to play naturally with free energy. Another reason could be that students try to control the evenness and quality of the sound, and because they don't have clinging fingertips that would just let them, you know, play with this kind of motion inside the tip of the finger and simply relax the hand and still hold on to the keyboard, not just fall down. So they have to just always keep some amount of tension in hands. So what would be the signs that the student is playing with stiff hands? The first sign might be that even in playing slow and simple pieces, a student would lift up his fingers too much, like, you know, I don't know. Explaining that, well, they're trying to play expressive, yeah, they do, I believe that, but they're not really using the correct way of conveying their ideas. Because if your hand is free and at ease and loose and relaxed and light and empty, it was just simply beautifully rest on the keyboard. And you don't need to lift up your fingers to express everything you want. What you do, you just apply weight to play anything you want expressive, you know. So you don't have to make all these motions. And if you notice in my play, whatever I play, it seems like it's so easy. It's just like I'm not applying any effort, which is kind of true because my hands are always at peace. My hands never overwork. Okay, so the next sign is that student would feel uncomfortable playing in slow tempo. They would actually say that actually they feel it's hard to play even in slow tempo. They use so much effort. And that leads to the next sign where students would complain they cannot really speed up because their fingers would stop moving, they feel stiffness in hands. And which is obvious because if they apply so much effort and energy while playing simple, slow pieces, then let's say they would keep the same level of energy while playing faster, and this is already too much energy. The muscles cannot breathe. What is happening, muscles simply stop breathing in and breathing out. They're suffocating in the stiffness, and that prevents fingers from moving. That's what's happening. So the point is, my dear friends, you don't have to use a lot of energy to play simple things. Moreover, it's like opposite. You can use very little energy to make everything you want in front of the piano. That's how it works. So how to get this feeling? First and foremost, just remember that all I need to do is just be aware of how your hands feel while practicing every single moment. And yes, they might not switch to new sensations right away, overnight, forgetting all the bad habits that you got during sometimes decades of from playing. And yes, you might not get the sensation of cleaning fingertips right away that lets you play with free hands, but it's okay because everything in this life takes time, perseverance, and faith. Second thing is you need to understand that all the tension we have while playing is only here in our mind when we are about to imagine sound, in our throat when we are connecting and singing distance between notes, yet our hands don't exist. So our hands is just a channel for our intentions to be conveyed to the keyboard. So it's just like, this is our intention here. This is the bridge to the piano. It's just a channel. And if you have any stiffness here, I could tell you guys that whatever you beautifully imagine in your hand, it will be just stop here. You will never get any response from the piano. So it's really crucial to keep your hand at rest and peace. And the last thing is that you need to also understand that after we touch the key, there is actually no effect on sound anymore. So there is no need to keep any tension in hands. Because what students usually do, they touch the key, they keep tension to the next one, they keep tension. When in reality, you touch the key and you release any tension right away. So basically, you imagine sound, you touch the key, you release tension. Then you gather again some energy because you are about to sing with resistance the sound to the distance to the next note that requires some kind of energy and tension. Yes, we touch the key and we release energy right away. And it's kind of so natural, but somehow on our journey of striving and struggling, we kind of forget completely how to make simple and natural things. It's okay, guys, it takes time. So, also I should say that it's probably wouldn't be easy if you don't have cleaning fingertips. Because what cleaning fingertips let you do is, and this step when you're about to relax your hand after you press the key, they will just, you know, like make this motion and you just hold on like to claw and you just completely can relax your hand. But if you don't have it, you would still have to keep some kind of amount of tension just to be able to hold on to the keyboard and not to fall down. So it's again, it's all right. Keep doing this, and I promise you that after some months, you will get this feeling of clean fingertips. And lastly, guys, I just want to give you the best and the closest analogy to feeling that I have while playing with loose hands. Playing with love. So when we are in love, we are gentle, soft, relaxed, at ease, caring, okay? So are you the same towards your piano playing? So make sure that you have the same attitude while playing, and the same feeling about your hands. Yeah, and it's always very natural, it's always very easy. Always remember, playing piano is a very easy thing. You don't have to practice like crazy for 6-8 hours every day. Losing completely the sense of while you're practicing, probably just because not to fail the exam. You can practice 1-2 hours 3-4 times a week and make great progress, and still have time to go outside, to communicate with people, to see the world, to understand who you are, to get the message. And that would be your true motivation, why you're going on stage and why you're practicing, because you want to deliver, you want to say something through your music. And to be able to say something, you need to have it in your mind. So please do not talk to the wood 8 hours a day. It's simply stupid. Besides, you know, after 2 hours, your brain will already switch off. You're just practicing your fingers. And then you're making probably some mistakes which you cannot even notice. And then the next day you will have to practice another 8 hours to just relearn what the mistakes that you made another day. Okay. Alright guys, so thank you so much for watching, and see you in my next video. Bye bye.